Hi guys, welcome to a mixed media tutorial for today. So today I'll be altering this cardboard tissue box that I had lying around at my house, and I'll be altering it using a lot of chipboards. So what you see over here is that I have already created a layout using resin, MDF chipboard, some laces. So whatever extra junk that I had in my box that you see, so that is where I store most of my mixed media supplies. So some of it is junk, like computer parts, old laces, some of it are clay molds, and some of it are MDF cutouts. So using those, I normally create a layout, and before sticking that layout onto the base, which is the cardboard tissue box, what I have decided is to add a coat of gesso to it. So since I did not want any color etc. showing through, I wanted it to be a thick white layer of gesso on top of it. I'm adding two layers of gesso, one after the another. You have to wait for a couple of minutes for the first layer to dry and then apply the second layer. Craft Angle's gesso is extremely fast drying, so a couple of minutes works. Now what I'm doing is I'm using Craft Angle's white texture paste along with Argyle stencil by Craft Angle's, and then I'm adding some textures to the places here and there. So again, in mixed media, the more textures you add, the final project will have a lot of depth. So you can add it in many ways. So one of it is stencil and texture paste, and you can also add it with spatula to certain areas, like how you see I did. Apart from that, you can also add layers of clays, MDF pieces, etc., which is what I'll be doing later on. Now again, the texture paste is extremely fast drying, however I am using heat gun to fasten the process. Once I'm happy with how everything looks, I start sticking my mixed media stuff onto the top of the gessoed surface. Now this can be anything that you have lying around. It does not necessarily need to be the things that I am using. Again, altering and mixed media gives you the freedom to even use the things that people consider trash, like used pencils, old mirrors, and then make something out of it. So I leave it completely upon you on what you want to use. And the glue that I am using to stick everything together is Craft Angle's gel medium. It is a medium which can be used for photo transfer, as well as it works really well with to stick many mediums like resin, MDF, glass, metal, etc. It is definitely one of my go-to glue for mixed media. So once I decide and I'm happy with how everything looks, I will wait for it to dry. So you can let it dry naturally. It will take 15 to 20 minutes to dry, or you can use heat gun and fasten the process. Once everything is dry, you can, again what I am doing is I am adding a coat of gesso to make sure that whatever I do. So earlier I was planning to do some spray painting on top of it, and I did not want the clay pieces or the wooden pieces to soak in the spray. That is why I am adding a coat of gesso, and as you can see, Craft Angle's gesso works really well on surfaces like resin, MDF, clay, etc. Once everything is dry, I have decided to color my tissue box blue, and I wanted a light color of blue. So what I have decided is to combine two colors by Craft Angle's chalk paint, that is Cool Jade and Snow White. So I'm using one part of Cool Jade to two part of Snow White, and I'm creating a light blue. And what I'm doing is I'm coating it on top of, as well as inside of the tissue box. since this is chalk paint, you don't need any primer for it. However, since we have already gessoed the surface, it will even adhere better. And as you can see, even one layer gives you a lot of coverage. With mixed media, whenever you are painting, make sure that you cover each and every nooks and crannies, because normally mixed media is one layer on top of the other. So at some places you may need multiple coat of paint wherever you know you have missed the nooks and crannies of paint, etc. With mixed media, normally you try and add as much depth as possible. Sometimes that is using sprays and sometimes it is using waxes. So what I am doing over here is, now I have a flat blue color on as the base of my tissue holder, and now I have started adding certain areas of interest. So wherever I have made textures, what I am doing is I am adding dark blue spray, which is Trendy Teal and Denim Blue. So I am adding combination of two sprays to the areas, and then I am using paintbrush to move that colors to the nooks and crannies. So what that does is it adds depth to wherever you see designs. So especially the intricate designs around the frames, the flourish area, the stencil, the areas where we have done stencil. So wherever it will find recessed area, it will go, the spray or the color will go and stick there. So the color combination, etc., completely varies on what you want to do. It's not necessary that you use the same colors that I did. However, when you are adding depth, try and use browns, blacks, or the darker shades of the base colors that you have used. So what I am doing over here is I am using combination of Trendy Teal color and Denim Blue color, which are the darker versions of the base blue color that I did, along with Carbon Black, which is the black spray. Again, as like all my videos, the link to all the products that I am using will be linked below. So as you can see that as I have started adding these darker shades, you can see the drama being added to the mixed media project, and that is what you want to achieve, and that is what will give the depth to the mixed media projects. Now, as I say, with mixed media you have a lot of artistic freedom. You know, at this point of time, if you don't like, you can go back and color the entire thing in a different color and you know start the same process again. Or you could add certain areas, you could add depth in certain areas, or you can remove that depth. Since these are water-based sprays, you can definitely go back with water and lift off the colors if you wish to. What I normally do is I start off with light colors. So earlier I added a lot of water and less of sprays, and I go on building up the color as and when I need, or once I'm more comfortable with what is the tonal level of the color that I want to add on my design. So you can go from light to dark as well and go on building the depth. Over here you can see that I felt the flourish area needed some more depth, and hence I went back and I have added more concentrated spray and I have not diluted it at all. So you can add colors like so as well. Now those were the shadows that we created. Now to add even further depth to the mixed media project, what we can do is create highlights. So what you can see is that I am very lightly airbrushing white gesso on top of my mixed media project. So what this does is it will create highlight on the project. So wherever I add white gesso, that combined with the sprays underneath, it will create a light color of that layer, and hence it will add highlight to my project. And if you add multiple layers of gessos, like how you see on the rectangle frame at the top left, then it will become completely white and that will add even more highlight. Now I have added some sentiments using Tim Holtz Small Talk and Big Talk stickers. You can use any sentiment of your choice, however I feel that with Tim Holtz sticker book you get a lot of options. However, the sticker are not extremely sticky and over the period of time they will wear out. So what I am doing is I am adding a layer of Craft Angles gel medium to make sure that whatever I use is permanent, and then I stick them on top of the base. Now you could stop here, the project looks really good, however I felt that I wanted to add even more drama on certain areas. So what I am doing is that I am using some Craft Angles gilding flakes in silver, and I am using some Fevicol. So the glue that I am using to adhere this gilding flakes is Fevicol, and I am first adding a layer of Fevicol on top of certain areas where I wish to stick the flakes, and then using the second brush I am removing the excess gilding flake. So I repeat this process to quite a few areas where I feel I need that extra shine, and wherever I feel that the gilding flakes are not properly sealed, I add another layer of Fevicol on top of it. So it's not necessary that you always have specific glues. Fevicol is a basic PVA glue which works on quite a lot of mediums, and it gives you good and satisfactory results. With gilding flakes, as you can see, even little goes a long way. So the small bottle by Craft Angles, which is indeed packed with a lot of gilding flakes, it will definitely last you a long time. So that was my tutorial for today. I know normally mixed media tutorials are quite longer, but then they do take a lot of time, and I hope you enjoy different type of art forms that we can work, and that is what I plan to do. I would try to bring as many art forms to you as much as possible, and I leave you with some of the close-ups of the tissue box that was created. And I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. If you did, don't forget to like and comment. This really helps me to decide which next tutorial should I create. And do consider subscribing if you like my videos. And I'll see you in my next video. Have a good day. Thank you.